r/AskReddit. What is 100% luck but people act like it's an accomplishment? Winning on a slot machine. If you know a serious slot player, they treat it like a science. They never tell you when they lose. More like they only tell you their winnings, never the amount they spent to make that, which is typically more money than they won. Hey, Vegas wasn't built on winners. Yes, they certainly do treat it like a science. I've heard my dad talk about his strategy for picking machines and how to win by playing the machines a certain way. It's insane. Whenever I hear that, I am reminded of the experiment with the superstitious pigeons. Put a pigeon in a cage. Have a food dispenser in the cage. Have it dispense food at completely random time intervals. Turns out, the pigeon will associate whatever the heck it had been doing at the moment with food being dispensed. Pigeon was scratching its feet, now it thinks scratching its feet will cause food to be dispensed. Pigeon was flapping its wings, now it thinks flapping its wings will cause food to be dispensed. The pigeon will then do that thing over and over again in the hopes of attracting more food. And, of course, because the dispensing is random, occasionally it will happen again. The pigeon counts those successes as further validation and gets its belief reinforced. Having rich parents. Definitely, there is a difference between making $1 million and being a millionaire. I drive a BMW and I'm 17. Success never sleeps. Didn't your dad drive you to school in that last year? My brother's GF in high school had a BMW X5 that she insisted wasn't new because her dad used the car for 6 months before giving it to her. Did anyone see that chick on Dr. Phil whose allowance went from $2,500 a month to $1,000 and was too traumatized to continue to go to school? Getting in early enough on a Reddit thread to get top post. Sort by rising. Leave a bunch of smartest answers. Karma. The trick is being a base comment in an established post. I once cracked an egg and it was a double yolker. I was proud of my accomplishment and claimed it as my own. You inspire me. Never change. Here's looking at you, kid. When somebody cites anecdotal results to justify bad behavior. I drank when I was pregnant and Tommy turned out fine. We never used car seats and nothing bad ever happened. I'm fine to drive. I've driven home plenty of times after a six-pack. In my day we used lead paint and nobody got sick. These are not actions that guarantee bad things happening. They are actions that increase the odds of bad things happening. Add to it my grandfather smoked a pack a day and make it to 95. PSSSHHH. Whatever. My grandfather drank a handle of whiskey every day and lived to be 118. A former co-worker I'm still friends with on social media won a $5 million prize in the state lottery last year. At first I was happy for her. She paid off her and her husband's house, put money away for her kids' college funds, and paid off all their student loans. But then the social media posts started coming in about how she deserved the trip to Spain recently, or how she was rewarded for hard work with a new Mercedes. Lady, you got super lucky winning a good-sized prize in the lottery, but did nothing to earn all this. I'd rather have seen a million blessed posts than this shit. At least that acknowledges the randomness. Back when I was in high school, our janitor, who was also the stepdad of one of my friends, won $3.4 million in Quinto. I believe he was the last or second to last payout before they shut down from lack of funds or something. But don't quote me on that. He was the most down-to-earth guy with that money I've ever seen. He paid off their house and their existing cars, bought a nice, big TV, and helped get the high school a new track because the one we had was legit garbage. The school got a state grant to help pay for the track, but still came up like $40,000 short. My buddy's dad just said I can cover that, and paid the rest of the cost. Then he put the money in savings and as far as I know has barely touched it over the next 10 years. He still kept his janitorial job, still kept coaching the track team, and basically stayed the exact same, crazy humble and always willing to help person that he's always been. I've honestly always used him as an example of the kind of person I'd want to be if I came into stupid amounts of money like that. Killing me in any FPS game. Lucky shot, kid. Nothing personal. My friend had wealthy grandparents who gave him an enormous inheritance. 2 condos and a townhouse. Several million dollars. And 2 luxury cars. When people comment on his sudden lifestyle change, He was working at Burger King previously. The dude says, "Yeah, I worked so hard, busting my ass every day, doing an online business to generate supplemental income. There were days where I didn't sleep and I wasn't sure I was going to make it. When I called him out in front of everyone for lying, he started to fake cry and say I was being a hater for him doing well. That inheritance is ridiculous lifestyle change for anyone of any age if they aren't in the right mindset. 3 homes and 2 cars with millions in cash can correct 75% of people problems. Money, living situation, reliable transportation, and all they have to do is not duck it up over time, which tends to happen due to personality traits, I bet. Winning the lottery frequently ruins people's lives because they have insufficient impulse control and no idea how to manage money. That's so funny to me. I think it was Andre Iguodala who said, "I thought I was so irresponsible after I got my first NBA check. I bought like 30 pairs of Jordans. I didn't even know how to blow money back then." Being born rich or good looking or well hung, 1 out of 3 ain't bad. If you hit the trifecta, sheesh. If you were born well hung, then you are probably suffering from medical issues now. Ah yes, I suffer from big dongleitis. In my country, India, thanks to nepotism, everything. We had new neighbors moving down the street, an Indian family. The wife mother of the family was a trained nurse and, when she found out that my mother was also a nurse, kept persistently asking how to get a job at the nursing facility where my mom worked. This went on for months. Every time we saw her, she would ask, "When can I work there?" My mother would tell her to apply at the personnel office, but apparently she never did. Eventually her husband explained that she was waiting for someone to call her because she assumed my mother had to recommend her for her to have any chance of employment. That's how it works in a lot of places. Also, the person who recommends the new employee gets some monetary benefits out of it. This just happened to me. It's a win-win because the person I recommended is someone I used to work with and I know how well we work together and that this person is reliable and smart enough to figure out the job. I've lived in Florida my entire life. There's a type of person here that likes to hang tight and not evacuate when a tropical weather system is approaching and they're recommended ordered to do so. And then flex on anybody who didn't call them kittens when it's all over. Those people are dumb. Also reckless, because emergency services will have to be wasted on them when they gamble and lose. Usually if they refuse to evacuate, most incident commanders will not risk their personnel's lives to rescue them, which is how it should be. The best way to convince these people to leave is to go around suggesting they write identifying info on their body so their corpse can be identified. Another way is to go around asking them to fill out next of kin notification forms for when they are killed by the storm, fire, flood, etc. And yes, this is stuff they actually do to convince these people. I feel like I remember hearing that authorities instructed everyone not evacuating from Katrina to write their name and birth date on their arm in Sharpie or something so their corpse could be easily identified. I can't help but wonder if anyone actually did it. I have had several instructors who were there for Katrina and similar large-scale disasters. Usually once you tell them something like "mark your body for its purposes," they suddenly realize the danger is real and agree to leave. Those that don't are often identified by dental records due to decomposition. Boobs. I grew these myself. Thank you very much. McDonald's and Chinese food helped me. My grandmother smoked a pack a day, drank a lot for a 70-year-old and ate like shit. We found Reese peanut butter cups hidden in a TV drawer once and caught her smuggling ice cream bars in her purse to her room. Yet she is the only grandparent who doesn't exercise and has yet to come across any severe injury or illness. For your information, my dad thinks she lives off the misery of others, which may be true. My grandma is 95 and lives a similar lifestyle. Everyone thinks she is alive still because she is making everyone miserable and sucking their life force from them. Being tall, like that is one thing people really have no control over. When I was 6, I had a Russian sports coach who told me to drink milk to get tall. I drank a shitload of milk every day till I was 11 and I just became a fattest kid. I'm 5 feet 6 inches. You got tall horizontally. On the same lines, Deal or No Deal was completely about luck, but presenter Noel Edmonds tried to make out that it was a game of skill. The only skill aspect I can think of is knowing to cut the shit and just take the banker's offer. better to settle for $300,000 than risk getting the $100. On the contrary, from a statistics point of view, you should never take the banker's offer because it is always slightly lower than your expected value at that point in the game. In practice, however, the money being offered can be life-changing, so you can't blame people for taking the offer. Being born in a developed country. By the same token, when people act all elitist for being from someplace cool like NYC, Colorado, California, yeah, maybe people like the place you were born. That doesn't mean they like you. Being born beautiful, it blows my mind how people really identify with it, as if they achieve it. It's even worse when they prioritize themselves in some way over someone who isn't quite as attractive. Also, I'm talking about genetic physical features here, not gym discipline, diet, etc. They identify with it because of the way others treat them as a result. I always wondered how being a beautiful young girl and the attention they get stucks with their conscience. Imagine every person checking you out no matter where you go and what you look like. You would have to be a strong person to not develop a huge ego. LOL. Being born into money, inheriting a fortune. I earned this. The old line about being born on third and going through life convinced you hit a triple is usually pretty accurate. Being born. Hey, I was the strongest swimmer in over 100 million. I earned this pitiful existence. Nationality. Duck, you say about America? USA, 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 USA. Accomplishment if you immigrate, maybe. Rolling a natural 20 at just the right moment. It's always good fun. But I've definitely had players try to pass off that amazing victory over that big duck in Dragon I threw at them as a result of skill. Despite the fact that the whole point of the game is that it's a random dice roll, and if it's not, then we kind of have a problem. In the true RP fashion, every player should damn well treat it as it's the result of skill of the character. Being born into a wealthy family, and then acting like you worked for everything you accomplished, when in reality, much of what you accomplished is a product of being born on third base. Honestly, even being born into a middle-class family is a huge advantage. You had a couple positive role models in your life. Maybe even other than your parents, someone read to you at bedtime, helped with elementary math homework every once in a while, you got to play a school sport because you didn't have to work full-time to help your family pay the bills, got a little advice on college applications because your aunt went to college. These are all advantages that are hard to quantify but will set you ahead of others from day one. I didn't see this here, but I think it's the most important one, winning the fight against cancer. Lots of luck involved here. Is it treatable? And did the treatment work? It's not easy, that's for sure. Being a successful online celebrity. I have seen a few channels from content makers that have these inspirational videos that just tell you to do it, and follow your dreams. And one day you'll have millions of subs and have your own studio in downtown NYC just like them. Sure, you aren't going to get to that level of success without the work, but they make it seem like it is a sure thing just because it worked for them. A lot of the time it is just the luck of the internet and something becoming viral that establishes a solid base for further progression. Without the initial surge, many of these people would never have taken off. It isn't 100% luck, of course, but it sure does help. Deflecting all laser blasts from a training remote with a lightsaber while wearing a helmet with a blast shield. Most folks that have been truly successful in life will tell you it's due to a combination of support from others, luck, and hard work. In essence, success is always due to external factors to a certain degree. Riding the accomplishments of your significant other, especially when they establish their wealth and success long before you met. Example. A girl I went to school with boasts about buying her first home at 23. She doesn't work, has never had a real job, and didn't go to college. Her very successful fiancé bought a home. She got lucky. Birthday. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.